already. I don't know what to talk about. There's so much shit to talk about, I don't know where to begin.
Your girl, was saying she was black. What's her name?
That's your girl. I forget her name. But that she was the head of the NAACP.
Rachel?
She got a sex tape out.
You kidding me?
Yeah, you didn't see that?
No, I ain't see that yet.
Yeah, this bitch got a sex tape.
I've been on the news all day and still didn't see that. I'm not surprised, though.
But that story set up, too, though. They're going to set that story up. Because they're going to push that along with the... Because, you know, you got that faggot shit. People say, I identify... You could be a man. A man, you can say, I identify as female. So soon they're going to start pushing, well, even though I'm white, I identify as black. And I identify as Chinese. That's all part of that New World Order fucking agenda. To bring everybody together.
Check it out. They ain't even got it done. So you can even change the birth certificate now so that nobody will fucking know that you got a sex change and shit. That's some crazy shit right there.
Hey, but a funny thing, that bitch might actually be black.
Oh, that bitch is Jake.
She an Israelite, you know what I mean?
Straight up Jake.
So in her spirit, she already knew.
But the Most High only making fun of that bitch because
right.
If she would have listened to the truth, she would have been able to explain it her way out of that.
Yep.
But, you know, they hear the truth and they reject it. You know?
But that's what she get for joining forces with the NAACP.
Oh, you know.
That was started by the so-called Jews.
Dumbass.
Yeah, they gonna get mad at this bitch for being white. But the whole organization was started by the so-called Jews. By the goddamn Edomites themselves. Black people did not start the NAACP.
Still don't run.
Just like the Southern Poverty Law Center and the ACLU and all that other shit is all started by the so-called Jew. Like that, it's a black organization. No, that's a fucking so-called Jew organization. And with Jews, you lose. People are so stupid, man. People are so easy to manipulate, you know what I mean? Oh, just like with that shooting today. They had that weirdo that went up and shot up that church. Where's that, South Carolina? Killed 9 people.
Like four or five of them was pastors.
That's good. And we've been saying the pastors gonna get shot up.
Yeah.
Pastor Porkchop got it coming. we've been wishing death on these churches.
That's just the beginning.
But people are so easy to manipulate, they're going to see that. That's gonna cause more racial tension. That's gonna help start the race war. Well, that's a good thing, though. You know, we've been saying the race war is coming, but we also know that it's a setup. It's a conspiracy. This dude was on some kind of drugs. What they say is on some amnesic drugs, like the drugs you take that gives you amnesia. You don't know what happened afterwards.
Yeah, of course.
He was
like,
drugged
like
up.
Sleeping pills like Ambien.
Yeah.
That causes amnesia, too.
Yep.
I mean, that's just an example.
Like the Halcyons. And
that's crazy.
So there's proof. They know for a fact the dude was on drugs. So that was the government. He was pretty much like a CIA government mind control agent. Just like Sirhan that shot Bobby Kennedy. And just like the dude that shot up the theater in Colorado, in Roark, Colorado, the Batman shooter. It came out that he was working at some university and he was on all kind of drugs, and he was working in some... Well, where is he working at? You remember?
That
Holmes dude in the Batman shooting.
Oh, yeah.
He was working in some kind of mind control center. Something crazy. I forget the exact words. But all this shit is set up by the government. First, to start the race wars and to take away people's guns. That's what that shooting was about. Okay, that was set up by the government. But we know this. The average retard walking around don't watch that. Nobody, I can't believe that racist. Goddamn racist. You see that racist shoot all those poor black folks?
I heard a guy at work today, man, he was like, man, that's still, it's sad, it's still going on to this day.
See, that's what I'm saying, that people are so easy to manipulate, man. But that's good you're easy to manipulate, because then the motherfucking devil's going to bring the hammer down on you bitch asses, and you're going to get fucked up, man. So we don't get fooled when events like this happen.
You know what I'm saying?
We already knew it was a government setup, an inside job. Just like 9/11, just like the Boston Marathon, was set up by the government. What's another one? The Oklahoma bombing. I mean, you name it, it's all set up by the government. Every time there's a bomb plot to blow something up, we come to find out it was the FBI who tricked somebody into setting a bomb up, and it was the FBI who supplied the bomb. It was a fake bomb. How many times have you read the newspaper?
Zero.
Because you're retarded. But the FBI always says they caught somebody about to set a bomb off, but every time you find out the FBI is the one who supplied the bomb.
Here, they ain't catching no drugs going on the street. No,
they the ones supplying the drugs.
You know what I'm saying?
They had your boy Geraldo Rivera on Fox News over in Afghanistan showing Marines guarding the poppy fields in Afghanistan. Because that's why there's a large amounts of heroin overdoses going on in this city and all around the country. Because they say the purity of the heroin these days is like 20 times more pure than the heroin they had back in the 80s and 90s. And it's powerful, and it's potent, and it's cheap. That's because the government's shipping all the drugs in. Okay? Just like the government, you don't know the government was behind that shooting at that church, right? We know this. The zombies, they don't know what's going on.
Yeah, they didn't know what happened.
They're clueless.
They still were trying to get over LeBron James losing the other night.
Oh, yeah, they worried about LeBron James.
You see the food?
Like,
they're
going to do better next year.
Oh, did they?
Yeah.
It said 2015, and I had the Cavs logo with the finals trophy up in it.
That's some funny shit.
Hey, yeah, your boy LeBron. I was watching that series, though. That shit was rigged, bro. We was watching the refs. Like, the refs would never call nothing on the Cleveland Center, that Moz guy. They would never call
LeBron
shit.
LeBron was in on it. He was throwing up the shittiest shots I ever seen.
He could very well have been in on it. You know? That center, the Cleveland guy's a beast. That white boy, Russian, he's a fucking monster.
He's real tough. He ain't, I don't think he's real good.
But he's young though, you know.
That motherfucker tough as hell.
But he ain't getting no calls. But that's because the refs are all set up. That's why it came out that, what's your boy, Tim Donahue got caught rigging games. Like, he's the only
one. Oh, look, LeBron would take like five steps. He took five steps and they didn't call traveling, but that one dude shuffled his feet like that and they called traveling.
I told myself I was gonna watch the last two or three games. I forgot the series the shit was going on.
I gotta give it to you. I watched the last game. And when Golden State won.
Oh, they was praising the most.
Yeah, they was all the crazy guys like
we go to the chapel every day before the game and
yeah, Iguodala said, well, what's your boy Curry? He's such a God fearing man and I don't know what they
He was like, when I grow up, I want to be like Stephen Curry.
Yeah, he said he's a God-fearing man. We know LeBron James ain't no God-fearing man.
He's Illuminati all the way.
What was we talking about? We talking about basketball now. I got to bring that, bro.
Proverbs 14 and 15. The simple believeth every word.
Oh, yeah, that's beautiful. The simple, the people out here, the simple believe it every word. Okay, because y'all believe everything the news tells you. You know what I'm saying? Anything the government tells you or the TV tells you, you believe it. When the television told you that a bunch of Saudi Arabians hijacked airplanes with a butter knife or a box cutter. A butter knife. If you know what I'm saying? And that they took down the Twin Towers, y'all believe that shit. That's how simple you are. Just like that shooting today. Y'all actually believe some weirdo went up in that church and killed everybody. You actually believe that? That's all good. Y'all can believe whatever you want, man. Keep believing everything, you know what I mean? Stay asleep. The Lord to put this spirit of deep slumber on you fools. But we ain't mad. We glad you asleep, actually. Every day again, man.
Proverbs 14 and 15, the simple believeth every word, but the prudent man looketh well to his going.
Yeah, so the prudent man looketh well to his going. So we don't get fooled every time there's a major event, a major shooting. We know what's going on. Because like I said, that shooting at that church, that goes back to the government's motto of problem, reaction, solution. So there was a problem. The problem was so-called racist white guy went up to the church, killed a bunch of so-called black people. So now That's the problem. The reaction was everybody's, oh my God, he's a racist. We got to take the guns away from everybody. So the solution is going to be martial law, gun confiscation. Okay?
The Latin term, order out of chaos.
Yeah, order out of chaos.
There's probably going to be another shooting tomorrow.
Yeah, it's going to multiply.
Oh, it's going to get worse. Well, they said they got Juneteenth coming up.
That's right.
So Juneteenth, that's already going on. So now they're going to have a lot of shit to bitch and complain about. So, you know, they're going to be down there crying about old
drumbeat, race riot.
Crying about, oh, the police brutality. And they're going to be crying about this
white supremacy.
And they all going to get caught out there, going right along to what the puppet masters have want them to do. Yeah, because they all these fools out here protesting, they're just like puppets on a string, you know what I'm saying? You got the Rothschilds up at the top pulling the strings. They just like marionettes, you know what I'm saying? Because they even said George Soros, a so-called Jew, that he supplied $30 million to the Ferguson protesters. And they had the Communist Party down there.
Go stock.
Jeremiah 14:10. Thus said the Lord unto this people. Thus have they loved to wander. They have not refrained their feet. Therefore the Lord doth not accept them.
Yeah, so the Lord don't accept these fools. Like all those people up in that church that got shot. I thought that was the house of the Lord. How come the Lord didn't protect them? Because that's not the house of the Lord. That's that house of devils. That's a whorehouse. Okay, and the Lord has sent us, even though it was the government set up, the Lord is controlling everything.
Everything.
So, you know what I'm saying? He killed two birds with one stone. You know what I'm saying?
Therefore, the Lord doth not accept them. He will now remember their iniquity and visit their sins.
Yeah, so there's going to be a lot more pastors and churches getting shot up. Believe it. Churches going to get burnt to the ground. And then when these churches get shot up, we laugh and we celebrate.
Get drunk on some wine.
Man, that's why I woke up this morning and read the news. That filled my heart with joy.
Pray not for this people for their good.
Oh yeah, so after that shooting, these people was outside in circle. They had like group prayers. Everybody out there praying. The Lord said, pray not for this people. Hey, you and Jeremiah, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. Oh, keep going.
When they fast, I would not hear their cry. And when they offer burnt offering and an oblation, I would not accept them.
So, but y'all was unacceptable before the Lord. Keep going.
But I will consume them by the sword and by the famine and by the pestle.
Yeah, the sword, that's that pistol. You know what I mean? And soon the famine's coming. Soon, what do you think when all these race wars break out and all this chaos and shit go down? Society's gonna shut down. Semi-trucks are gonna stop moving. What y'all gonna do when the truck drivers stop delivering goods to the store? Ain't gonna be no food. Plus, we out here in Columbus and all these other cities, all these highly densely populated areas. You got all these people in one place, and ain't nothing around here but concrete. Ain't no crops growing. Ain't no food. So when those semi trucks stop moving, people, y'all gonna starve. There's gonna be a great famine. Oh, like they said, California is like the breadbasket of the United States, right? Look at that great drought they got going on in California. They starting to shut people's water off.
It's getting worse and worse.
It's getting worse and worse. Oh, it's going to be hell. You think it's hell? We think we live in hellish conditions right now? Wait till they totally run out of water out there in California. Up in L.A. Motherfucking L.A.
Place is already a desert.
It was a desert when they. Only reason they They set up irrigation systems when they built the city. So all that water that LA has is coming from, what, the Colorado River or something?
Right, right.
I think, you know what I mean? But I do know originally LA was a desert. And it's going
the whole West Coast.
And it's going to return to a desert. There's a lot of people in LA. There's a lot of motherfucking people in LA. And the majority of them, they're going to starve. They're going to kill each other. We like dog eat dog. Cannibalism, race riots. You will have white versus black, blacks versus Mexicans. Man, it's gonna be crazy out here.
Christians versus Muslims.
Yeah, yeah. You got they shipping Muslims in by the millions. Mm-hmm. Now they walk around like they own the fucking place.
They do. They're hand in hand with the homosexuals.
Yeah, y'all Muslims are so real. Why don't you start killing some of these faggots?
Ezekiel 33 and 27. Say thou thus unto them, thus said the Lord power, as I live, surely they that are in the waste shall fall by the sword, and him that is in the open field will I give to the beast to be devoured. And they...
Oh, you sent me a text not too long ago, say your girl got attacked by a dog.
A few days ago. Got ate the fuck up too. She got 50 something stitches.
People think we joke when we say a dog would get you.
50 something stitches, man. Got ripped part of her titty, and broke her arm, and stitches on her.
Your wife?
No, this girl I know. Remember the Jew? Hey, I met y'all. The girl I was with. Her.
Yeah.
Yeah, because them animals are spiritual creatures.
You probably sensed her adultery on her.
But the animals could sense you. Oh yeah, just on the way up here, I seen somebody had a just a pit bull just running around. Well, he was somebody left him outside. But I seen him, he looked ferocious, like he would bite your damn arm off. But I seen him, I'm like, what's up, doggy? And you know, he smiled. But if that pit bull would come across someone as evil, he would attack him. Oh, you remember that dog we had, Ugly? Everybody was scared. I had this dog named Ugly. Everybody was afraid of him. He's the scariest looking pit bull you'd ever seen. What's wrong? Hey, bro. You be all right. Get you some,
You want to use mine?
That's mine. I do mine. I do part of mine back here. You got to treat your boo with more love, man.
Man, some of these Bibles, they're made very cheaply.
Yeah.
Because they don't expect people to read their Bibles.
Right. They expect them to buy them, though.
And they fall apart very easily. Yeah. Once you start using them.
You're not supposed to open them. You're just supposed to
it's for decoration.
Hold them and walk around with them.
Yeah, certain Bibles are definitely made better than others.
And they that be in the forts and in the caves shall die of the pestilence. For I will lay the land most desolate.
America is going to be laid desolate. And desolate means the soul, death soul. Soul means one, right? Like solo. So there's not going to be a single person left. It's going to be a turn to a desert. Right, just like Revelation 18 says. It's going to be the... You know, I should just get it. Let's get Revelation 18. You know when it says it's going to be the number three.
Yeah, that's two. 18 and two.
Yeah.
I'm starting one.
The foul of every hateful and unclean.
Revelation 18 and one. And after these things, I saw another angel come down from heaven, having great power, and the earth was lightened with her glory, and he cried mightily with a strong voice, saying, Babylon the Great is fallen. Fallen.
And Babylon the Great is America. Because Babylon means confusion. And America is the land of great confusion. Oh, it's land. Look, we was driving up here on the way down here down High Street. And what do we see? On almost every single building that had faggot flags flying. We was down on Broad Street going down. Was that Front Street or Marco?
Yeah.
Front Street. It wasn't Front Street. It was the homosexual street. They took the street sign out. The actual name of, you know how to, like, Like, get that on the name of the street on camera. You know how they got the street sign? On the street sign on Front Street, it was a faggot rainbow flag on the actual street sign.
They named it the Stonewalled Pride.
Well, what if you had a... So what if you had a Moses Boulevard?
Yeah, how a shy way.
There'd be mass protests, you know what I mean? But everybody's cool with this faggot shit. You drive down High Street, they got faggot flags flying on every building, almost every building. Rainbow flags are flying. So, it's the land of great confusion. The Lord's going to destroy this shit, man.
Babylon the Great is fallen. It's fallen. And it's become the habitation of devils.
Right, so after America's going to be destroyed, the only thing that's going to be here is like spirits, evil spirits, lizards, snakes, vultures, you know. Yeah, owl, screech owls. Oh, we get that, Isaiah. Oh, go ahead.
And it's become the habitation of devils.
Yeah, get Isaiah 30.
And the hold of every fruit, foul, and the hold of every foul spirit, and a cage of every unclean and hateful bird.
Right, vultures. What's some, you know.
Back to Ezekiel 33:28. For I will lay the land most desolate, and the pomp of her strength, shall cease, and the mountains of Israel shall be desolate, that none shall pass through. Then shall they know that I am the Lord when I have laid the land most desolate because of all their abominations which they have committed.
And that happened in the ancient world too. What happened before the Babylonians sacked Jerusalem and burnt the temple to the ground? Israel was being wicked as hell. You know what I'm saying? There wasn't nobody following the commandments. So the Lord sent the Babylonians on them. They seized Jerusalem. You know that when they seized Jerusalem, nobody could get in or out of the city when the Babylonians seized it. So they cut off all the food supplies, and then people started eating each other. It was mass cannibalism. You know what I'm saying? Because they had no food. And people say, I'll never eat a person.
Yeah, okay.
Go a month without food.
No, I've heard people say they ain't got a problem eating a person.
Yeah, I've heard many people say that. You're right. But yeah, so then the Babylonians came through. And they laid Jerusalem, they laid it desolate. Burnt the temple to the ground.
Damn, what the fuck?
They took the gold. You know what I'm saying?
What the fuck is that?
Is that a Ferrari?
Yeah.
What the fuck is that?
That's gonna get laid desolate. That's gonna get burned up. You know what I'm saying? It's gonna be destroyed. And then whoever's driving it, most likely is probably gonna go into slavery. Or be destroyed. They're gonna be reincarnated in slavery. I was getting back to, but yeah, like the modern day Babylonians is going to seize America. You know, in the ancient the Babylonians destroyed Jerusalem, but now Russia's going to destroy America. They're going to lay America desolate.
They just said they're building 40 more nuclear warheads.
40 more. And they said it's a response to NATO's activity. Russia ain't fucking around. Russia's going to shoot missiles on America. They ain't going to be no more goddamn America.
Yeah, them missiles
must
aren't.
Think America's whole is surrounded by missile defense systems that a missile can't touch this place, man.
Oh, they can touch it.
Yeah.
That's why Russia know they got missile defense systems. So that's why they making
America
sure.
They ain't got none. That's the thing. Right, they probably protected NORAD, but they ain't protected America.
Oh, yeah, you're right about that.
They ain't protecting this.
Well, I'm saying, Russia is making sure they got plenty of missiles in case.
They said the missiles are going to take out their missile defense system.
Yeah, right. Because they got the missiles that juke.
Yeah, they got juking missiles. They got dummy missiles.
Oh, let me show you. No, I'll show you later.
Yeah. I wish you got Isaiah 34, too. This goes right into this.
There's a whole lot of missile. Every nation is practicing their missiles, man. You know,
testing them.
Everybody, that's what I meant, testing. I said practice.
It's practice.
Everybody's testing them, man. It's coming, man. It's coming.
I can't wait, too.
It's coming, man.
There ain't gonna be no faggot flags flying on that day. You know what I'm saying?
It's coming, man. That's something to be happy about. That's something to lift the spirits on.
That's good, though. That's a wicked
man. You guys hate Jews, right?
hate Jews?
No, we hate Edomites. We're Jews, you're not. Fucking faggot. Faggot ass Edomite walking down the street.
You guys hate Jews, right?
Big fucking faggot. Needs to be punched in his face. Now he's gonna go into slavery. You got Isaiah 34? Can you see where I want you to start? Yeah, just start at 1. Now you go ahead and read that.
Isaiah 34 and 1. Come near, you nations, to hear and hearken, you people. Let the earth hear, and all that is therein, the world and all things that come forth out of it. For the indignation of Yahweh is upon all nations.
Yeah, so the indignation of Yahweh, the Most High God, is upon all nations. Keep going.
And his fury upon all their armies. He will utterly destroy them. He have delivered them to the slaughter.
Right, the Lord delivered them to the slaughter. So it's the Lord is behind all this chaos, all this militarization is going on. That's the Lord behind that. It's the Lord is moving those pieces on the chessboard. You know what I'm saying? Keep going.
Their slain also shall be cast out, and their stink shall come up out of their carcasses, and the mountain shall melt with their blood.
The mountain shall melt. Keep going.
And all the host of heaven shall be dissolved, and heaven shall be rolled together as a scroll.
Now read that again. Now this is a key point. Break this down. Read that.
And all the host of heaven shall be dissolved.
All the host of heaven shall be dissolved. A host is an army. The heaven's the sky. Keep going.
The heavens shall be rolled together as a scroll.
The heavens shall be rolled together as a scroll. That's talking about a nuclear missile. A thermonuclear missile. You know what I'm saying? So all those the airplanes, jet fires, it's all gonna be destroyed. Keep going.
And all their hosts shall fall down as a leaf falleth off the vine, and as a falling fig from the fig tree.
Right, because you're going to have the military. They're going to try to fight against the angels, too. They're all going to get destroyed. Keep going.
For my sword shall be bathed in heaven.
My sword shall be bathed in heaven. And once again, the sword being bathed in heaven, the heaven is the sky. People think heaven, oh, that's the pearly gates. Nah, man, that's the sky. Keep going.
Behold, it shall come down upon Edomah.
It shall come down on it. Was it Idumea? Yeah, that's another way of saying Edom. It's gonna come down on Esau. Okay? And Esau, that's the people, that's like that faggot, he was an Edomite. Those are the rulers of the earth, is the nation of Esau. The Rothschilds, those are Edomites. And Edom means red. That's why Rothschild's name is Rothschild, because Roth means red. So all those rich banker families, those are all Edomites. All these little faggot, little white yuppies you see, those these little rich kids, those are fucking Edomites. They all living real good right now. But read that.
And upon the people of my curse to judgment.
So Esau is the people of the Lord's curse. Okay, and they're going to get their judgment. And their judgment is death, destruction, and slavery.
The sword of Yahweh is filled with blood. It is made fat with fatness, and with the blood of lambs and goats, with the fat of the kidneys of rams, for Yahweh have sacrificed and I just said Esau.
That's one of Esau's cities.
And a great slaughter in the land of Idumea.
Yeah, Idumea. That's just another way. When you look it up, it says Edom in the Hebrew, I do believe. Because Idumea, that's Latin, right?
Yeah.
That's just a Latin way of saying Edom, or Latin or Greek. That's what it's pretty much the same. But they kind of switched up on that scripture. Usually it just says Edom. Keep going. There should be more to that. Because this talks about the same thing that Revelation 18 talks about. Keep going.
And the unicorns shall come down with them, and the bullocks will again. With the bulls, and their land shall be soaked with blood, and the dust made fat with fat. What is the day of Yahweh's vengeance, and the year of recompense? The year of recompense for the covenant. Say, what did I say, covenant?
all controversy.
That's a payback.
Zion.
Yeah. So they're gonna be paid. He's gonna get paid back. He's gonna get paid back. These devils done did all kind of wickedness. We've been talking about the wickedness they've done this whole time we've been teaching so far. All those false flags, killings, putting people in slavery, genociding people. Keep going.
The streams thereof shall be turned into pitch, and the dust thereof into brimstone, and the land thereof shall become burning pitch. It shall not be quenched night nor day. The smoke thereof shall go up forever.
That's that everlasting hellfire. When people talk about everlasting fire, you're gonna get tossed into that everlasting fire, into hellfire. That's talking about that destruction. When the Lord brings that great destruction upon America, that's the everlasting fire. And the smoke, and this is like parabolic talk too, the smoke's not actually gonna be going up forever. But it's gonna be destroyed. It's gonna cease to exist, okay? And that's the everlasting fire. You hear about it. What's that? Because people try to say this is a scripture. In Thessalonians, it speaks of everlasting fire, I believe, or destruction. You know what I'm saying? That's in Thessalonians. I could look it up. Because they'll try to use that to say it's talking about hell. But we know that's not true, because in the book of Isaiah, it tells you, names the name of a land, Bozra, and that the Lord's fury is coming down on Idumea. And the smoke is going to continue to the heavens forever. And then it also speaks of it in Revelation. And the book of Revelation also says that the smoke shall continue forever. And it's not talking about mythological hell. It's talking about destruction on this earth. Destruction on America. Other parts of the world will be destroyed too. But the main destruction is coming right here in America. This is the center of all the filth on the earth. Can you do a word search real quick? You got that scripture? Can you look it up?
What'd you say again? I got...
The Thessalonians? The everlasting fire or destruction?
This might be it. Well, it's talking about Esau's downfall, though.
Yeah, read it, read it.
The man of perdition, you know.
Yeah.
This is 2 Thessalonians 2. I'm going to start at 1 anyway. Now, we beseech you, brethren, by the coming of our Lord Yahushua, the anointed, and by our gathering together unto him, that ye be not soon shaken in mind, or be troubled, neither by spirit, nor by word, nor by letter as from us, as that the day of the anointed is at hand. Let no man deceive you by any means.
Yeah, let no man deceive you by any means.
For that day shall not come except there come a falling away first, and that man of sin be revealed, the son of perdition.
And who's the son of perdition? It's Esau, okay?
Who opposes and exalted himself above all things that is called the Most High, or that is worshipped, so that he, as the Most High, sitteth in the temple of the Most High, showing himself that he is God. Remember ye not that when I was yet with you, I told you these things? And now ye know what beholdeth, that he might be revealed in his time. For the mystery of iniquity doth already work.
Yep.
Only he who thou letteth will let, until he be taken out of the way. And then shall that wicked be revealed, whom the Lord shall consume with the spirit of his mouth, and shall destroy with the brightness of his coming.
That's when the Lord gonna come back out of the sky. He's going to come out with legions of angels.
Legions.
I mean, there's going to be all kind of destruction. You're going to have the Lord going to come out the sky with the chariots. But you also going to have that third world war. And there's going to be some thermonuclear missiles flying. You know what I'm saying? We don't know exactly what order all these things is going to happen. But we know it's coming. But the Lord said he's going to come out the sky with legions of angels. And he also said that Russia's going to shoot missiles on America.
Yes, sir. Even him whose coming is after the working of Satan with all power and signs and lying wonders.
Yeah, because Satan, everybody knows about the Illuminati now. That's the Esau. Esau is the one behind the Illuminati. That's the Edomites. Starting with the so-called Jews. And all these rich elite families. Like, you ever hear the Fritz Springmeier's book, the Bloodlines of the Illuminati? It should be changed the name of the book to the Bloodlines of Esau.
That's right. The Bloodlines of the Edomites, yeah.
Fritz Springmeier probably don't even know that. Done did all that damn research. You know what I'm saying?
Here we go.
Everybody shit froze up.
And with all deceivousness and unrighteousness in them that perish, because they receive not the love of the truth, that they might be saved. And for this cause, Yahweh shall send them strong delusion, that they should believe a lie, that they all might be damned who believe not the truth, but have pleasure in unrighteousness. That's America. Columbus, Ohio, in particular, since we're here in this motherfucker. They had no pleasure in the righteousness.
No, they got no
or truth.
No, they ain't no none. No, not a single. If you speak anything that even resembles righteousness, you get casted out. You know what I'm saying? You get they look at you like you're the heathen. You know what I'm saying? Just like I said, we was driving down High Street, every fucking building has a rainbow flag on it. Every fucking building, damn near. It's disgusting. Even the city of Columbus themselves changed the name of the streets to Faggot Streets. And put rainbow flags on the street signs. I already made a video on one of the channels about how you go down Broad Streets and they got the homosexual flags flying all the way down. And I see something else on the internet the other day. The school system, I think it was down in Florida. I'm not really sure where this is at. I forget. But they was allowing the Church of Satan to pass out the Church of Satan pamphlets to elementary school students.
Oh, yeah,
and the school
that.
Students.
I remember that. Yeah, because the same thing was going on here in Lancaster, Ohio, but some of the residents rose up against it, you know. And plus the KKK was down there handing out flyers with the devil worshippers.
The KKK's devil worshippers too.
Same shit.
That's just set up by the government. That's Freemasonry. Your boy Albert Pike, he's a 33rd degree Freemason. Let this goddamn plane go by. Hope it falls out of the sky and crashes into a church. Yeah, but Albert Pike, well, he's a 33rd degree Freemason. And Freemasons worship this guy. They say he was one of the greatest Freemasons to have ever lived. He pretty much wrote the handbook on modern day Freemasonry. And he was one of the founders of the KKK. So what does that tell you? Oh, and the KKK also used the Templar's cross. Go back to the Knights Templar.
Come on, look. 311, KKK, 311.
Yeah, that is 311, right?
33.
Yeah, it equals 3. We add it up, it's 33. Yeah. That's no secret either. And it goes back to the Knights Templars. Because modern day, even the Freemasonry actually come from the Templars. They'll tell you that. You know what I'm saying? If you look, go on the websites and shit, they'll tell you we're going back to the Templars. Because originally the Templars were. We ain't going to get into that history. Because originally the Templars, from what I understand, that was our people that started that shit. But it got hijacked and. They started worshiping Satan and all kind of crazy shit. You wanna learn about the Templars, just study the Crusades. You know, the Templars were also the inventors of banking. You know that? They invented modern banking. Like when you go put a deposit somewhere. If I deposit something in a bank, I can withdraw my money in a whole nother country. They was the first ones to do that. That, you know, so you know the so-called Jew came through and hijacked that shit. Oh, also talking about the so-called Jew, that's a good point. Because Albert Pike himself, the father of modern Freemasonry, Albert Pike said all Freemasonry is based on the Kabbalah, which is a so-called Jewish mysticism. That's what those devils over there in Israel to this day practice. With Kabbalah isms. And Albert Pike said Freemasonry is based on the Kabbalah, which shows you that connection to them so-called Jews, to Esau, the Edomites. Oh, my fault. You gotta read something?
Yeah, I'm gonna read this. Wisdom of Solomon 16 and 16. For the ungodly that deny to know thee were scourged by the strength of thine arm with strange rains. With strange rains, hails, and showers, were they persecuted that they could not avoid, and through fire were they consumed? For which is most to be wondered at, the fire had more force than the water that quenched all things, for the world fighteth for righteousness. For sometimes a flame was migdictated that it might not burn up the beasts that were sent against the ungodly, but themselves might see the perceive and perceive that they were persecuted with the judgment of the Most High. And at any time it burneth even in the midst of water over the power of the fire, that it might destroy the fruits of an unjust land, America. Pleasure to condemn this wicked ass people, man. Oh yeah, let me think.
I got a precept. Revelation 19:1. And after these things, I heard a great voice of much people in heaven saying, Hallelujah, salvation and glory and honor and power unto Yahweh our power. For true and righteous are his judgments, for he hath judged a great whore, which is America, and one of the numerous nicknames of this filthy place. So we got all kind of names. Just like we always call this place a filthy cesspool, a fucking hellhole. The Lord got all kind of names for it. He calls it, likens America unto Babylon. He calls America Sodom, Gomorrah, the Great Whore. You know what I'm saying? There's many nicknames for America. For true and righteous are his judgments, for he hath judged the great whore, which did corrupt the earth with her fornication, and had to avenge the blood of his servants at her hand. Isn't that what America did? Corrupted the whole earth with that filth and that degeneracy. Because over in all them other countries, they want to be just like Americans. You know what I'm saying? They want to, motherfuckers over in other countries, you name a country, you got motherfuckers over in bumfuck Egypt and Romania or something rapping a Tupac. You know what I'm saying? Or watching Hollywood movies, wanting to be like John Wayne or because America makes all the movies in the world. They starting to dwindle in their movies and shit now. But America started all that shit. All the homosexual shit, it all started right here in America. All the women's rights. You think they got women's rights in Saudi Arabia? Oh, hell no. But they trying to push it over there, you know what I'm saying? They trying to do it. Yeah, go ahead.
2 Ezra 14:16. For yet greater evils than those which thou hast seen happen shall be done hereafter. For look, how much the world shall be weaker through age, so much the more shall evil increase upon them that dwell therein. For the truth is fled away, and leasing is hard at hand. For now hasteth the vision to come which thou hast seen.
So great evils are going to come. The evils are going to be multiplied. Like we already mentioned a lot of the evils. Some of the evils done hit that church in South Carolina. They got a little taste of that evil. And the government, they're going to start killing more people. They're going to stage more false flag events. You know what I'm saying? They just going to start mass murdering people on a grand level. So, you know what I'm saying? Race riots is going to pop off, the famines, cannibalisms. We can't wait. Let me read the rest of this.
Motherfuckers gonna see it.
Oh, they gonna see it, all right.
Yeah.
They gonna be frightened. They gonna be scared to death.
Horrified.
You're right, horrified. What's that? There's a scripture on that. I forget that scripture. What's that one that says, they'll faint, their faces. What's that one that says they'll faint? I can't exactly remember. We read it all the time.
Faint will be like B.S. Lemon or something like that.
Yeah,
I think that's Jeremiah 49.
Revelation 19 and 2. For true and righteous are his judgments, for he had judged a great whore, which did corrupt the earth with her fornication, and hath avenged the blood of his servants at her hand. And again they said, hallelujah, and her smoke rose up forever and ever. That goes back to what we was talking about, that smoke. So the Lord said he gonna judge the great whore. And then, because that's an actual place, that's an actual country, a physical place on this earth. And then the smoke's gonna ascend to the heavens forever. So that's not talking about hell. Well, actually, that's real hell. You know, he actually got missiles called hellfire missiles. They like to shoot off of helicopters and fucking airplanes. They're called hellfire missiles. The real hellfire is those missiles. That's the hell. And that is hell. That's a fiery flame. That's fire and brimstone.
Come down and sit in the dust, O virgin daughter of Babylon. Sit on the ground. There is no throne, O daughter of the Chaldeans. For thou shalt no more be called tender and delicate. Take the millstone and grind mill. Uncover thy locks. Make bare the leg. Uncover thy thigh. Pass over the rivers. Thy nakedness shall be uncovered. Yea, thy shame shall be seen. I will take vengeance, and I will not meet thee as a man.
The Lord ain't coming back as a man. He gonna come back in his full power. You know what I'm saying? Because when he first walked the earth, he was walking around as a man, flesh and bone. He even died. You know what I'm saying? He came back to life. Now he's coming back. He ain't coming back as a man. He's coming back in his full power. Dancing and when it starts raining missiles, we call that dancing in the rain. It's gonna be raining missiles. Let's see him dance. Let's see y'all dance and party and have a good time when it's raining fucking missiles. Let's see you dance and party while the whole damn city's burning. You know what I'm saying? You getting robbed and raped. Men gonna get raped too.
Can't get a drink of water and just.
Yeah, there ain't gonna be no water. People gonna be so desperate, they're gonna start drinking. Dishwashing liquid and shit.
Pissing each other's
mouth. Yeah, pissing each other, drinking piss. They gonna be eating shit. It's gonna happen.
Yeah. Cooking shit.
They gonna cook the shit.
Cakes. Shit cakes.
Like Aaron Madowski, I don't know if he was telling the truth. He said back in the Vietnam War, they was stuck somewhere and they didn't have no food. They was baking, cooking shit and eating shit.
That's crazy. As for our Redeemer, the Lord of hosts is his name, the Holy One of Israel. Sit thou silent and get thee into darkness, O daughter of the Chaldeans, for thou shalt no more be called the Lady of Kingdoms. I was wroth with my people. I have polluted my inheritance and have given them into thine hand. Thou didst show them no mercy. Upon the ancients hast thou very heavily laid thy yoke. And thou sayest, I shall be a lady forever, so that thou didst not lay these things to thy heart. Neither didst thou remember the latter end of it. Therefore hear now this, thou that art given to pleasures, that dwellest carelessly, that sayest in thy heart, I am, and none else beside me. I shall not sit as a widow, neither shall I know the loss of children. But these two things shall come to thee in a moment, in one day, the loss of children and widowhood.
Oh yeah, your children are gonna get killed. You know what I mean? Your husband's gonna die. You gonna see him die before your eyes. See little babies' heads get smashed. Your husband, somebody gonna come through. The cops could come through and kill you. Kill your husband. Or say even some gangbangers could come through. kill your husband right before your eyes, blow his goddamn head off right of his fucking shoulder, bash a little baby's head right up against the wall, kill him, and then they gonna rape the woman. This is gonna be all, I mean, this is the terror of the Lord is unimaginable.
That's right. The days of evil are ahead of us.
There's evil, and the Lord evil. And the Lord is bringing that evil.
That's right. What's evil mean? Bad times. That's what evil mean, bad times.
He almost got broke.
I almost was about to zoom in on him, too.
Oh, shit. Should have got him. Like, that wasn't as bad as that dude last week. I got a crick in my neck.
Oh, yeah, dude had to go down there and lay down. He got fucked up. He was fucked up. Okay.
He's still over there about to get fucked up.
Fuck him.
I want to see him get broke.
Was he trying to do a trick or something?
He's just trying to rob.
Fucking, we get into the good part. Let's get back at these scriptures. I was getting hands up. I got a scripture ready to come out.
Isaiah 47:9. But these two things shall come to thee in a moment, in one day. The loss of children and widowhood, they shall come upon thee in their perfection, for the multitude of thy sorceries and for the great abundance of thy enchantments.
Right, the sorcery, America is literally controlled by devil worshipers. And people say that's crazy. Like I always say, I brought this up a million times, I'll bring it up again. Who's the top Democratic candidate for president? Is Hillary Clinton, right? Or they call her Hitlery.
Hill Dog.
Hill Dog.
That's a motherfucking show.
Hill Dog. She's going to be the first black dog. Female president, right?
Right, right.
Fucking the first hermaphrodite president. Bitch is a lesbian. She got a penis and a vagina. But anyway, when she was in the White House with Bill Clinton, she was doing seances in the fucking White House. She actually held a seance with all kinds of rich, powerful people around her, all politicians, all of the elite was there with her. You know, they was all having a seance, and she said she summoned up the spirit of Eleanor Roosevelt to help guide her. And Obama even made jokes about it. So he was down with it too. They in the same party, you know, they had the same philosophy, same beliefs. So he's doing the same shit. And you can one look at Michelle Obama, you know that bitch is a witch. Mm-hmm. A goddamn sorceress.
Burn them. Burn them all.
Heathens. Children.
No spirit having heathens. They got just as much spirit as Bobby Christina Brown laying in as a vegetable in that bed.
Oh, she's still on life support.
Yeah, they got that bitch on life support still. Them some dead children,
yeah,
two daughters.
They look like children. Weirdos.
Yeah, they creepy looking.
Right. You know they've been getting raped? I guarantee you Obama's having sex with his children.
Those Joe Smith's people.
I would not doubt it.
I guarantee, Michelle Obama too.
Well, I heard the news about Chrissy Bobby or whatever her name is. I was at work and I just started laughing and they was looking at me like, why are you laughing?
Right. They don't understand.
These fools better fuck up my scripture.
That's funny.
I was about to go and bring a scripture out real quick.
They ain't gonna come this way. They gonna cross the street like that. Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
They know better.
I'm not in the mood to talk to no Mormons
they
right
know
now.
Better. I'm in the mood to curse them out.
Well, I'm not gonna curse them out, but you know. You
in the
know
mood
what?
To job kick them.
We got more important stuff to talk about than how Mormonism is retarded.
Some non-wisdom having motherfuckers.
We already know Mormonism. Get them faggots on camera. Dude. We already know that's the Church of LSD. The Church of LSD. So you gotta be high on fucking LSD and PCP to call yourself a Latter-day Saint. You know what I'm saying? If anybody's a true Latter-day Saint, that would be us. Because meaning the latter day.
You know, your girl.
And it's because work, they ain't no goddamn, they're the ain'ts. They're the latter day ain'ts. Not the latter day saints, the latter day ain'ts, because they ain't shit.
Here comes your girl.
Can you imagine the swim to the
you know,
it's hot and humid. She ain't
I bet,
dress
I bet
on.
She get all kind of dick.
Oh, yeah, right. They beating that shit up. They eating the ass out of everything.
Yeah, they eating that. They getting up in it.
Eating the ass out, man. And they are. You can watch them eat videos eating ass and stuff. Just come through the internet. Eat
their
ass out.
It's probably more BBW videos than anything.
Yeah, that's some hot shit to these motherfuckers. That's some hot shit to them, man. 10. For thou hast trusted in thy wickedness. Thou hast said, none seeth me, thy wisdom and thy knowledge.
Right, like these devils, they think nobody knows that they're witches and warlocks. And people, they look at you like you crazy when you say that.
Because that's where their power lays, in their secrets.
And their sorcery.
Just keeping it all secret. They're able to keep their power.
If you bring that thing up about Hillary Clinton having seance, they're like, oh, that's no big deal. Right. That doesn't mean nothing. That doesn't.
Because they applaud that when it happened.
Man, if that doesn't prove it, that 100% proves it.
They sell Ouija boards at every...
Right, you go to one... Right, good point. They got Ouija boards in the children's section. That shit works, too. We messed with the Ouija boards when we were little kids, back when we was young. We watched them... I think we watched that movie. That goes Hollywood again. Put shit into our minds. Remember that Ouija board movie they had back in the 80s? It got everybody interested into the Ouija board.
Yeah, it just works.
He hitting it.
Huh?
He already hit it, so why would he even give a fuck?
He want to hit it again. He want to lick that butthole.
Yeah, but another good point, too. Like, these devils think nobody sees them. Why? Because they're part of what? Secret societies. All the Bush family, George Bush and John Kerry, they on record on TV, both saying they're part of the Skull and Bones at Yale University, a secret society. And when they asked John Kerry what goes on in Skull and Bones, and he said, did he say I'd have to kill you if I told you?
Yeah, that's what he said, yeah.
And he's not lying, he would have to kill you.
Yeah.
And he probably has killed people. The government's killed many people to silence him, so he ain't lying.
What was that band that one of the members just came out and said he used to go to snow parties where they murdered people for fun?
Yeah, no, the bass player from the Scorpions. Ooh. Yeah, the bass player from the Scorpions, he said he went to snuff parties where you had to pay $100,000 to get in, and you could murder children, rape children.
There's a movie on that, so it has to be.
Hostiles.
Yeah.
Yeah. So he's just another dude bearing witness to the truth. He had to get them skeletons out of his closet.
Yeah,
he had like that guilty.
Yeah, clear conscience.
You know, the Scorpions had some bad music. That's
yeah,
good shit.
That's an Israelite to have a conscience.
Oh,
like
he's definitely a Jake.
Yeah.
Scorpions, that's good shit, man.
Scorpions, I ain't really listen to this.
But you know, come on, you know that Hurricane song.
Right.
Or what's that one song? Was it Rock Me? You know, that's some super commercial music.
Mm-hmm.
But even though I don't own no, I ain't never bought no Scorpion CD. But you know, I mean, that shit come out, it sounds pretty good, you know? Because that lead singer, that guy, he can sing, man, he can blow.
I'm gonna throw in some Scorpion and get reminded. But you're right, though, he has to be a Jake to clear his conscience.
Yeah, he gotta clear his conscience. He been holding that in for years.
Mm-hmm.
And he feels now, since all the truth is coming out, now it's safe. Oh, that's disgusting. You get on a camper, hurry.
Looks like Humpty Dumpty's about to fall off the goddamn wall.
That's a good point, though, because right now we in the time of, we in the age of truth. All this truth's coming out. So you're going to have a lot more people coming out with truth, because now they feel that since so many people's bringing out truth, they feel safe now. You know what I'm saying?
For thou hast trusted in thy wickedness. Thou hast said, none seeth me.
Right. That's why they call it secret societies. Nobody sees them. That's why Freemason temples don't have no windows. Because you can't see it. You don't know what's going on in the Freemasonic temple. There's no windows. Because they think nobody can see me. Well, the Most High sees you.
That's right. That's right. The angels. That's right. None seeth me. Thy wisdom and thy knowledge, it have perverted me. And thou hast said in thy heart, I am and none else beside me. Therefore shall evil come upon thee.
Right, so a great evil's going to come upon these fools. And it's just like your crazy dude was out here a couple weeks ago. He said the Freemasons were onto him and they wanted to... I don't know. That dude was nuts.
Oh, yeah.
But he said that... He kept talking about Freemasons and how interested they were in those demons. You know?
Yeah.
There might be some truth to what that dude was saying.
Yeah. Therefore shall evil come upon thee, thou shalt not know from whence it riseth.
Yeah, it's gonna be, your ass.
And mischief shall fall upon thee, thou shalt not be able to put it off. And desolation shall come upon thee suddenly, which
here's
thou shalt
buddy.
Not know. You got any water now? My throat is fucking sweet.
Oh, the water boy.
Been playing that foosball, boy? It's hot as fuck, man.
You get one if you want.
Tell you, man, we got a great reward coming, man.
Look, he started running over here. That's your Jew homie, ain't it?
Harold and Kumar?
Oh.
That's Harold and Kumar.
Oh, the one that's trying to be like Jake on his tank top on and shit.
That's, yeah, the star David.
That shit was funny as fuck, yeah, man. He was all embarrassed and stupid as fuck, didn't he? He was stupid as fuck.
He thought he had it. He thought he was in there.
That's some funny shit, man.
Yeah, that's some funny shit. That heathen is a fucking, it's an amazing thing, the heathen.
Some freaky thing. What's up, bro?
Yeah, I pulled all the shrimp you got on anything.
I'm loaning you a scripture.
Oh yeah, we got unlimited riches. Y'all want some gold? We got gold. He ain't got nothing but a. We got gold, they got aluminum foil. You know what I'm saying?
They said they didn't want none.
Rusted cast iron.
Oh yeah, they got some rusted tin.
Here we go. Okay, where am I at? All right, let me read 11 again. Therefore shall evil come upon thee, thou shalt not know from whence it riseth, and mischief shall fall upon thee, thou shalt not be able to put it off. And desolation shall come upon thee suddenly, which thou shalt not know. Stand now with thy enchantments and with thy multitude of thy sorceries, wherein thou hast labored from thy youth. If so be, thou shalt be able to profit. If so be, thou mayest prevail.
What the fuck is he doing?
They're doing a stunt. They're going to get fucked up. Yeah, but that scripture he's reading. If you even look at the holidays, even the holidays that we celebrate in America and in the Western world, all the holidays are based on what? Sorcery, witchcraft, astrological signs. Like Christmas is based upon the worshiping the sun. And they say also that it's during the time of Capricorn, which is ruled by Saturn. Mm-hmm. And you know, they just all bug that on this astrology shit, right? Mm-hmm.
Pick one.
Truth?
Yeah, the truth.
Alright, there you go.
Alright,
let's hear it.
Where y'all from? What nation are you? What's your nationality?
States.
What's your nationality?
U.S.
You're a U.S.?
Yeah.
You're a US?
United States of America.
You're an American?
Yeah. Why?
Where are you from? I'm from Israel. I'm an Israelite. Okay.
My dad's from Israel.
You know, those are not the real, get Revelation 2 and 9. You know, those are not real Jews, right? We're the real Jews. Those are not real, those are impossible.
I don't know.
Israelis? Yeah, that's why they're called Israelis and not Israelites. They tell you right there.
And Jewish.
Jewish. Let me read a scripture to you, bro.
That's kind of fucked up.
Everything you've been told the whole life is a lie.
It's kind of fucked up how they lie.
It's fucked up how they lie.
How are you gonna say they lie?
They do lie. Well, actually,
they
don't.
How are you gonna put a judgment on every single Jew that lives in
Israel? Well, I never said every single. I never said that.
Okay.
Because some of our people might be scattered over there.
You have to understand when they say Jewish, it's like saying Christian. But
well, because Jew is a race. That's a Jew is short for the tribe of Judah. Christian means the anointed one. The only people that were ever anointed is the nation of Israel, the Israelites.
What are you?
I'm an Israelite.
Were you born?
We're the anointed ones.
So they are real Jews. They are real Jews. They're not Israelites.
Give me a Revelation 2 and 9.
Okay. So the difference between you and the Jewish man, as myself, is different.
Hurry up and get that, please.
This is Revelation 2 and 9. I know thy works and tribulations and poverty, but thou art rich.
So the Lord said we're poor. The so-called Jews in Israel are not poor. The so-called Jews, they own all the banks in the world. They print the money that's in your pocket.
How is a wealth
they own Hollywood. They own the media.
How is a wealth status going to determine whether
they own the government? There you go.
Yeah, how is
I agree.
How is your wealth status going to determine?
We're reading the scripture.
Well,
we're backing the scripture
up. For the most part, keep going.
But thou art rich, and I know the blasphemy of them which say they are Jews and are not, but are the synagogue of Satan.
Synagogue of Satan. There's Jews over there, actually the synagogue of Satan.
Revelation 3 and 9. Behold, I will make them of the synagogue of Satan, which say they are Jews and are not, but do lie.
They're liars.
Behold, I will make them to come and worship before thy feet.
So they're going
to
bow down.
How did you guys get? How did you guys get?
We're prophets.
Where do you guys start?
How did a prophet start?
I don't know. Like, who told you?
The Most High put the Spirit on us.
All right, man. Like, where are you from?
So why are you guys preaching it here and not over in Israel?
Well, Israel's going to be destroyed. The Lord's going to destroy that. The Lord has to destroy Israel with fire because it's been defiled.
Look,
those are not the real Jews, bro. Don't you know, even in the Jewish encyclopedia from the Jewish encyclopedia.
Where are you from?
Even tells you
I'm
that.
I'm an Israelite.
Where are you from, Columbus?
Oh, no, the Jewish encyclopedia says that modern Israelis are actually Edom. They're actually Edomites.
Yeah, the Torah?
No, not the Torah. The Jews don't follow the Torah anyway. They follow the Talmud.
I don't know
where you born
at.
What does it matter?
They don't follow the Torah.
What do they follow?
I just
want to know, like,
Bible? They don't follow the Torah.
What do they follow?
We already agreed that they own all the banks, right?
So? What does that have to do with
it? It's got a lot to do with it. You said they follow the Torah.
Guys.
And why they charge people usury?
I'm trying to understand.
Why they charge people usury? If they
understand, walk away.
To charge what?
Usury.
What is this here?
Interest. Charging people interest.
What? To study this Torah?
No. There's a law in the Torah that says you're not supposed to charge your brother interest. But all the banks owned by all charge interest. That's usually.
You show me what that says.
I'll show you right here. It's in Deuteronomy.
How do you feel?
How old are you?
Right, let me get this real quick. Deuteronomy 23 and 19. Thou shalt not lend upon usury to thy brother.
What is usury?
Usury of money, usury of victuals, usury of anything that is lent
is
upon
that
you.
What happened? You turn to the basic Christian belief and not rather
than money. Said money. Said money.
All right.
When you're talking about the interest that like,
you guys are
like
all born in Israel? No, they weren't born in Israel.
That's because of business. It has nothing to do with those.
Second, well, the Bible says whoever denies that
we were all there
the Christ,
when we were born here in this nation here. But
liar.
The Lord scattered us here for our sins. Uh-huh. We're not following his ways. That's why we're here.
Do you shave this right here?
No, I don't shave. Razors ain't something touched me in years.
Really?
In years.
Damn, dude, I wish I was that fucking lucky. I gotta shave
shit,
all the time.
Shit, I wish, you know, it's a curse that
what?
I can't grow a beard. It's
why?
A curse. It's a curse. I just told you, they're curses. We're under, the children of Israel are under curses over here. And now, you know...
Wait, you can't grow a beard?
Yeah, that's a curse.
Really?
There were people ancient times that was under David that they had their beards cut off. But they were forced, they were told that they got to be out the congregation until they grow their beards back. So
blessed?
It's a curse. Yeah, well, you know, you can consider it a blessing to be able to grow a beard if you want. But it's, as far as I'm concerned, it's a curse that I can't grow a beard the way I want. No, you ain't supposed to shave.
Would you consider it
you're not
a
supposed
curse
to shave.
If I can grow a beard?
What?
You consider it a curse if I can grow a beard and I
no,
can't
no,
not have
blessing.
Hey, let me ask you a question.
Ooh, what's the difference between it? Maybe I personally
not
don't like shaving.
No,
hey, did y'all know about the Jewish circumcision
yes.
ritual?
We actually just learned about that.
Yeah,
so that's a godly act, right? To suck a baby's penis?
Yeah.
So that's what your people do. They molest children.
That's right.
No, when a Jew male baby is born, they get a rabbi, what they call a mohel. They come in, they circumcise the baby, then they suck the blood out of the penis. He probably drinks and swallows.
They say the saliva heals them.
I don't believe that.
No, it's true, bro. Get on Google. Google Jew rabbi sucks baby penis.
It's all over.
I don't want to Google that.
There's been babies that died from catching diseases from your
people. No, it's not my people.
You said it's catching venereal diseases from your people. I mean, they're right now still currently still trying to pass laws to convict those rabbis in New York City right now.
No, because they had passed laws in New York, the state of New York.
Oh, it's crazy.
They're trying to stop it because babies were catching AIDS.
See, the Bible is a front for them. They don't really believe in the Bible. They follow
CBS News.
The Jews follow ancient Babylonian ways. So their holy book is what they call the Talmud, you know? And in that Talmud, man, you just do a research. Do this. Do a search. Like crazy things in the Talmud or crazy teachings in the Talmud, and just read it, what comes up, you know. Don't let's do what's coming out of our mouth. Go read it yourself.
I got something better to read though. Watch this. 1 John 2:22. Who is a liar but he that denieth that Jesus is the Christ? He is the Antichrist that denieth the Father and the Son. So that's proof they're all liars right there.
Right now, they believe the Lord is burning in shit and piss in hell.
Yeah. Who is a liar? Who is a liar but he that denied that Jesus is the Christ? Like he just said, the Talmud says that the one they call Jesus is forever burning in human excrement.
Well, and they say they haven't had the revelation that you guys have had.
They're never going to get it.
Well, they're not Israelites, so they're not going to receive this.
It's not for them.
How do you know?
Because they're not Israelites.
But they could become Israelites.
No. You just can't wake up one day and say, I'm born to be an Israelite.
So you were born in Israel.
I was born an Israelite.
You were born in Israel.
Not in the land of Israel.
How do I know if I'm an Israelite?
How do I know if I'm an Israelite? My father was an Israelite. Through the Spirit.
I got a scripture.
How do I find that?
You're calling people liars just because
read this book.
You're not
believe the Lord, you know?
Israelites.
The Spirit hit you?
No, I said, who is a liar?
They're all going off. Well, there's going to be people out in the churches, out of Catholic religion, that's going to be delivered.
Did you hear about that the other day? The guy went down to South Carolina.
That's a joke.
You think that guy did a good job?
Let me show you something.
You're telling me that guy did a good job?
Well, it depends on how you look at it.
The Lord put it in him to make him do that.
Let me just read something for you,
all right? Hold on, let him speak. We don't have one speaker at a time. Otherwise,
it's just confusing.
It gets confusing.
You guys heard about that shooting down in that
South Carolina?
That was set up by the government. That was another government.
So the government did a good thing.
That was a government inside
job. So the government do a good thing by killing all the Christians?
They're not Christians. Those are pork chop. Those ain't Christians.
They went up into a church.
There's a bunch of pork chop
preachers teaching
lies.
Did you watch the news?
I watched it. They're not. They might call themselves Christians. They're not teaching the truth.
But I'm saying that. They
deserve to get shot.
Listen,
that's fucked up.
This is Isaiah 45. Listen, man, this is Isaiah 45. 45 and 7.
The Lord let it happen, didn't he? The Lord's in control of everything.
Okay. Before you say that,
I form the light and create darkness. I make peace and create evil. I, the Lord, do all these things. I form the light and create darkness.
Okay.
I make peace and create evil. I, the Lord, do all these things.
No, those preachers down there in that church, what are they
doing? The devil was controlled by the Lord.
Those preachers in that church,
Satan,
got shot. What
he's
are they
controlled
doing?
By the Lord.
Wait, can I go back to what we were talking about before?
I think it was just that.
But they're robbing people every Sunday of everyone's money. Yeah, they're sitting around the opera plate.
All right,
can
we go back to what we were talking about before?
No, they're no good. It goes in their pocket to the Escalades or the Rims or whatever. What's hot these days? I don't know.
From what I heard,
their private jets.
The shooting was racist, so
well,
it had to do
that's
with
what you learned from the TV. Did you know that he was on what they call it, amnesiac drugs? He's on drugs that causes amnesia. He was under some kind of mind control. He had hands.
My God, he's under mind control. My God.
He's in control of everything. Yes. Ultimately.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
But what I'm saying though, that shooter had handlers, just like the Batman shooting. You know about the Batman shooting? That was the government behind that. The government was behind the Boston bombing. It's like the government was behind 9/11. the government is going to use this to what? They're going to use that shooting.
Where did you come up with all
this? To start the race wars, fuel the race wars, and to take away everyone's guns.
Man, there's a lot of shit to pay attention to what's going on, man. And eventually, the dots are...
Can I ask a question?
I've been paying attention.
So I know.
I used to know like all that shit. And like, I don't know, man. It's like, why would I just say
so
why
it's all
that?
Part of
let
it.
Let me read this. This is Proverbs 16 and 4. The Lord hath made all things for himself, yea, even the wicked for the day of evil.
Yeah, I mean,
damn, that's a scripture.
So all these things the government's doing, they stage these false flags all the time. Even like Sandy Hook. They try to use a Sandy Hook shooting.
Everyone that found Israelites basically died.
Well, yeah, this is what I want to get to. So why do you guys shun people that are different from you? Rather than just accepting the fact that... Why are you guys shunning the Jews that aren't...
The Lord gets back?
...that you don't consider Israelites?
When's he coming back?
Where's that going to get you?
Nobody knows.
What are you talking about?
Where's he going to be?
Jack, he's teaching the Bible.
Amos 3.
He's
going
to crack them clouds.
That'd be fucking awesome, dude.
It is. You're going to see it. Listen. He's going to crack them clouds with thousands and thousands of other chariots. Those chariots are UFOs. You're going to wake up one day and you're going to see giant, you're going to see the whole earth covered.
Yeah, those UFOs, no, that's right. The angels.
Spooky shit, huh?
It's not that
crazy
ancient,
shit, huh?
It's not that ancient aliens.
It's all in the scripture.
You know what I'm saying? That's the angels and the Lord.
That's right.
That's where you get that song, Swing Low, Sweet Chariot.
Swing Low.
Let me read this and I'll continue that.
Amos 3:6. Shall a trumpet be blown in the city and the people not be afraid?
Or blown the trumpet out here.
Shall there be evil in a city and the Lord have not done it?
So, yeah, so the Lord ultimately, he's the one who brings the evil.
You have a good one.
Creates
you
the too, buddy.
But what you said, we're out here teaching the Bible to the Lord. Said teach the gospel to all nations.
Don't be mad at the messenger.
Holy shit! Might be scattered amongst these people.
Shit, dude.
Oh my
What's
God! Get over here,
bro.
Don't be mad at the messenger. Why not? You guys are sort of making the world worse. The world can't get no worse. Now we're educating.
Get a lot worse.
Which was spreading truth and light. What are you doing?
What am I doing? I'm
playing video games.
I'm not teaching people to stone other people.
Okay, so you're making the world worse.
How is that making the world worse? I'm accepting differences.
Where's Brent? No truth?
No, I don't know.
Who determines the truth? You?
What's 2 plus 2?
What are you doing there?
Boy.
The Lord.
That's 6.
My dad.
2 plus 2 is 6.
It is.
Alright, prove it. According to this world, we out here educating people, bro. We're waking up our people. Like y'all didn't know, dude, that government, that the government was behind that shooting.
What's that happening?
It has a lot to do, bro. That's true. It has a lot to do. Because what does the scripture say? We're aware of the wiles of the devil. Okay, the devil, we ain't tricked by the devil. So you watch TV and that TV just manipulates you.
Really?
Because
some people, they consider you guys the devil because you're shunning
people. Of course.
People.
They crucified the Lord and killed him. They killed him. Put his spiritual aside. And then they said, we have no king but Caesar. And they killed him. Then they killed Peter. Hung him upside down on a cross. And then they killed all the disciples.
Second Corinthians 2:11. These Satan should get an advantage of us, for we are not ignorant of his devices.
See, we're not ignorant of Satan's devices. So, like that shooting at that church, as soon as that happened, we found out he was on mind-altering drugs, just like every other shooter before him. It was obvious he had handlers.
I'm sorry, that's fucked up.
Job would be nice. Job, book of Job.
What you need?
Go get your audio Bible.
Hmm?
Go get you an audio Bible.
I think you spread some positivity.
An audio Bible? The book of Job?
This ain't a jukebox, bro.
500 oxen or 500 sheep.
Yeah, he's a wealthy man at one time, right?
Farmer auctions, he was very...
he was wealthy. There was wealth back then.
Wealthy, holy man.
Had a nice family.
And Satan came.
Right.
He told God, he said, why are you here?
Satan did what?
Satan approached God. And he said, what brings you here? And he said, I was patrolling the earth watching everything.
Running here and to and fro, right.
And he said that, look at Job. He's the only man
the most
in the high level, a lot of integrity. Right. And he said, take away everything that he has, and surely he'll curse your face.
Right.
He said, all right, do what you want with him, but don't hurt him physically.
Right. Well, don't kill him.
Yeah, right. Don't he took his.
He messed him up.
His Old Testament.
Right. Right.
And he took his. He took his kids.
Took his wife.
Right.
Wealth. Everything.
Did we judge you?
And Job did not. Job did not.
Curse the Lord. Didn't curse the Lord.
Not in Israel.
Let me get the other camera ready.
You're not a fucking Israelite. Where you from, man?
Yeah. Why
not? Look up what an Israelite is.
Okay. All right. Not me, but my.
Citizenship. I mean, this is a little township.
I know what that's like.
I was raised Muslim. Okay. I brought up Muslim. My family is still currently Muslim.
Okay. But you read the Bible, though.
Right.
You
believe in the Lord, though, right? New Testament in my pocket.
Okay. You believe in the Lord, though, right?
Yes. Jesus Christ is the Lord, your Savior.
Right. Okay. That's good. Because that's the truth. That's where the truth lies, is the Lord.
And I have both the Old and New Testament in my bag right now.
Okay.
And, you know, I appreciate what you guys are doing here. I was just sharing a little story because, I mean, a little experience that I have.
We all like Joe's. We all can relate to him, you know what I mean? We all can.
I'm currently homeless right now.
Right.
That's okay because I'm not going to be homeless much longer.
That's right. That's right.
I know God to provide for me. He's been providing for me. He's been providing for me, so I know that God's good. But we find homeless people around here, and they stop by. Just a suggestion, because I can relate to the story of Job a lot. Because even though I'm not like Job as far as integrity goes, I do have a lot to relate to him. Whereas, like, I kept my faith in God, but once I had hardship come to my life, and whether God allowed Satan to come into my life and, you know, take what I have in my life, I've done the opposite of Job. I've actually got angry at God, and I said, oh God, why did you let this happen, God? I've been faithful, I've done everything that I'm supposed to do.